Thank you. Oh, Princess, don't sneak up on me like that, especially when I'm working. So, what do you think? Oh, you like it? Well, that makes one of us.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear.
Thank you.
Honey, you have to come out. She's waiting for us. Don't make me do this by myself.
No, I don't want her to see me like this. I'm sorry, I can't.
Don't make me do this by myself.
No, I don't want her to see me like this. I'm sorry, I can't.
Why would you do this? What am I supposed to do now? I can't do this without you.
I need you. I need my medicine. Oh, please. Oh, it hurts so much. Why won't you help me? Why are you punishing me like this? Whatever I did, I'm sorry.
Thank you. still feel something. I look at you and I see nothing. Not the beautiful girl I fell in love with. Not the mother of my child. Not even the hateful monster you pretend to be. You're just empty. I look at you and I feel nothing. It scares the hell out of me.
Say how hideous I am. Go on, I know you want to.
God, not that again.
I know you're disgusted with me, admit it.
Right, I am disgusted with you. But it has nothing to do with the way you look. I'm disgusted with what you let it do to you. How you let it change you.
All right, honey. Something got into Mommy's eye, that's all. You be a good little girl and go to sleep. Daddy's working, so we can't disturb him. Mommy has to go downstairs and take a bath. I love you.
More than a wife, she was first and foremost his muse. Her beauty and talent drove him. After the accident, she became a burden, a disgusting monster screeching out from her bed, an anchor weighing him down.
All right, young lady. Shall we continue? Right. Whatever happens, just keep looking at me and listen. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. The princess was all alone in the dark. And yet, she felt that the evil witch was lurking nearby. As her eyes adjusted to the darkness, she saw something moving in the corner of her eye. And yet, she did not dare to move, for she knew that that would be the end.
Keep your head straight!
And yet, she did not dare to move, for she knew that that would be the... And yet, she did not dare to move, for she knew that that would be the end of her. The princess heard a fearsome growl. The witch had unleashed her familiar, the hellhound. The
monster sniffed at the air. Its perky ears wary of even the slightest sound. The princess remained motionless, letting the monster pass.
Eyes front, young lady!
There was a stillness in the air. The princess breathed a sigh of relief. For a moment, it seemed like the worst was behind her. And yet she knew that it was not over. There was still danger nearby, waiting for her slightest move. Frozen in terror, she kept looking straight ahead. Suddenly, she heard a terrifying cackle. It was the evil witch herself. The wretched thing despised beauty and innocence, for she had neither. The hag was near, just outside of view. The hag was near, just outside of view, but our heroine didn't dare to look. She had to keep her head
still. She didn't dare to look!
She had to keep her head straight, lest she be cursed by the witch's foul magic. She could almost feel the chilling touch of the witch's hand at her neck. She felt the sudden urge to run away, but fought it with all her will, for she knew that was precisely what the witch would have wanted. And then, just like that, the chill was gone. She saw a glimmer of light over the horizon. The sun was almost upon her. It was almost dawn. It was almost over. And there, the princess stood triumphant in the sun, smiling as she... Wait, that's not right. Her face, why is she still scared? Oh, God. I didn't mean to... Princess, I am so sorry.
It's not that he was cruel. It's just that, to him, reality was just a pale reflection of art. He was blind to the world, unless it was translated to him through a canvas.
Thank you.
I don't know what I expected to find. A farewell note? A final will? What I found was an apology. Expressed in the only language he ever truly knew. At that moment, I could finally see my father for what he was. A man driven insane with sadness and guilt. Trapped in this house, a nightmarish echo chamber of past mistakes and tragedies. It was this house, a place beyond hope, beyond redemption. I knew what I had to do. I had given up trying to understand my father a long time ago. But I could finally forgive him. Hey, Princess. What have you got there? Oh, that's so lovely, sweetie. But why pink?